doing today? I hope you guys are doing so, so good out there. For today's video, I'm teaming up with Nordstrom to bring y'all the 6 essential shoes that everyone needs in their closet. So a few housekeeping things before I get started. Number one, as always, everything mentioned in today's video will be down below in that description box, along with sizing, pricing, and affordable alternatives. Second thing, the structure of this video. We have the 6 essential shoes, but within each category, I have a couple alternatives because I am cognizant that you guys have different styles out there and also different needs that might be different than mine. So since I do have a crap ton of shoes, I wanna at least give you guys more choices in case you're kind of figuring out which one is better fit for your lifestyle. I've timestamped each one of those categories down below in the box so you guys can just skip around and get what you need a lot faster. And lastly, I do always wanna mention with these types of videos, like this is all just my personal opinion. It's not the end all be all. I'm just sharing my personal style preferences and learnings at this point in time. All right guys, so on that note, I love you so, so much. Thanks for hanging out with me today and let's get started. All right guys, so starting off with essential shoe number one, we all need an everyday flat. To me, the everyday flat should not only be comfortable and super walkable, but it's also timeless and classic and simple enough so that you can wear it with different articles of clothing and also matches with everything and can also be worn with different dress codes. So my number one draft pick for the everyday flat is going to be by the company Me Too, and this is the Audra Loafer Flat. Reason why I picked this one, number one, it is so freaking comfortable. If you guys look on the insole here, it actually has these rows of like puffy, bouncy little jelly rolls, and they can really just stand up and take a beating through a long day of walking. And I am incredibly partial to a pointy toe. I think there's something that's just a little bit more edgy and trendy and also kind of like leg elongating about it. And you also have like a rubberized sole on the bottom, so you don't have to worry about slipping. Next thing I really love is menswear. So I like that it does look like a loafer. However, it's kind of cut like a flat. Like it has a lot of exposure, so it's more of a sexier cut. And lastly, since this guy does have a back, I can wear it for casual occasions, but I can also bring this guy into the office. For under 90 bucks, I think it's a really great value. So that is my number one pick. My alternatives to this guy, if you're not feeling this one, would be my second favorite most worn flat, the Halogen Corbin Loafer Mules. I love these shoes so, so much. And especially since I got them at discount during the Nordstrom anniversary sale, it was just like a plus plus. These are actually a second new pair that I bought as a backup. If you guys are super on the go and you don't have any like professional or formal needs, like if you're working at home all the time, like this is a great alternative, because you can literally slip in and out super easily and you've got all of like the timeless, seamless, simple look and appeal of the Me Too flat. Since these guys are pretty much sold out, I'm going to find some alternatives for you guys on the site. And then my third and last recommendation for an everyday flat, if you guys are into a more feminine and classic style, would be ballet flat. Now, I don't have a physical pair of ballet flats to show you guys, but if you guys are into that style, I highly, highly recommend a company called Yossi Samra. Super famous for making the ultra comfortable, foldable, easy to transport ballet flat, super high quality, and the fact that you can like fold them up and throw them into your little drawstring tote and take them on the go, like it is just like the bomb ballet flats. I've had one pair in my lifetime and they were crazy good. The reason why I don't have a physical one here is because I have just been phasing them out of my closet because I just love that pointy toe so much, but I wanted to make that note for anyone out there that's looking for a classic, more feminine style. Essential shoe number two is going to be the sneaker. It's pretty self-explanatory. This is your athletic, ultra, ultra walkable shoe that can be used for a street style look or just everyday casual. Number one pick for my essential sneaker is going to be my classic white Supergas. They've got an all rubber, really sturdy, thick sole, and then the actual upper body is all canvas, so you can loosen or tighten the body really easily to just conform to your foot. And I'm so sorry, mine are so dirty. I've been traveling so much with these, but the great thing is that you can throw these into the washer and get them all clean again. I think this is an Italian made shoe. It's timeless. And I actually prefer these over Converses because since my foot is wide, I noticed that the actual width of the sole is a little bit wider. They come in a lot of different colors and like variations, so I'll link all those down below if you guys want to check out a few options within the Superga family. And if the Supergas are too plain and simple for you guys, if you like a more street style or a more athletic look, I highly recommend the Nike Juvenates. These guys are crazy popular for a reason. These are just so lightweight and breathable. cool, amazing for travel. I also think that this is a great shoe that if you are an active person and need a sneaker that you can go like from the gym or to training into everyday life, this is a great option. And then my last recommendation, if you guys want something in between these two, would be an Adidas Superstar or an Adidas Gazelle. I really feel like it's a good marriage because it's kind of got like the body of a classic sneaker like the Supergas, but you got that sporty, edgy graphic appeal of like an athletic shoe all combined in one. I love both Nike and Adidas for different things, but I think Adidas does a really great job marrying the sportiness with the classic style. All right guys, moving on to essential shoe number three. Since this video is about like all year round, let's talk about a summer warm weather shoe. This category is so hard because there are like so many different types of sandals, but if I had to pick one type, it would be a hybrid lace-up sandal just like this one. This was my favorite pick this year. This is from BP, and this was the Decker lace-up sandal. Reason why I picked this one is because it has a little bit of everything that I need. I always wear cute, like, flouncy dresses and really feminine things during the summertime, so I do want something that's a little bit more fashion-forward and cutesy. It's got a little bit of a heel, but this guy's stacked and chunky, so even though you get that nice height in the leg, it's still sturdy and comfortable enough to walk all day long, and then you also have really great skin exposure that's really suitable for the warm weather. So if I had to pick one summer sandal, it'd be something like this that's a nice mix between fashion forward and comfort. Now, if you guys don't need anything like super dressy or cutesy, my first alternative would of course be the classic Birkenstocks. The Arizona Soft Footbed is seriously the most comfortable flat sandal. I love that it's like so minimalist, like you can literally wear these with everything, but it's also super timeless, like you can wear it with any stages in life and you can walk miles and miles in these. So love these guys if you need a flat summer sandal. And my wide ass feet appreciate these so much. And then lastly, I just want to throw these guys in because if you are a high fashionista and want something that is, you know, really, really dressy or something to go out on the town in, these two have been my favorite summer wedge. Reason why I threw wedges into this video is because they are more walkable high heel. First ones being by Jeffrey Campbell. These are from 2-3 years ago, but he's made different variations on these, but it's that really cute perforated laser cut out corseted open toe wedge. Definitely check these out if you are more into a romantic, sweet, feminine look. And then my second favorite would be these Mark Fishers. These are the Adeline Espadrille wedges. You guys see me wear these so much. They're cute, they match with lots of different things, and they got that really cool espadrille roping on the bottom. Essential shoe number four is going to be the ankle bootie. Now, I have these two over here, which we'll talk in a little bit. You guys know I love me some ankle booties, so this was also a really hard category to choose from, but when I thought about it, I was like, no brainer. My number one pick for the ultimate ankle bootie is going to be a splurge, but without a doubt, my all-time favorite. These are the Rag & Bone Margot booties. There's just something about the height and the look and the comfort and the, you know, impeccable design and make of these ankle booties that I just know that I'll love for a lifetime. You've got a cap, rounded pointed toe, a little notch in the front, dual zippers for easy access, and then the actual pitch and the sturdy thick heel just makes your legs look amazing, but it's also crazy comfortable. Like, I've worn these for 6-7 hours straight without any problem, and they just feel like ultra high premium quality. The only downside to this, of course, is that these are super pricey. Regular price, these guys are like $500. I've never bought one at full price. I've either bought them during the Nordstrom anniversary sale or found them, you know, on sale when they're out of season or at Nordstrom Rack. So if you guys cannot find them full price, don't worry, I've never bought them at full price. This is one investment shoe that I think is so worth it. I'm gonna love this design for like ever, and the quality is just unmatched. And then these three on the side, I wanted to bring out from my archives just as like sample alternatives for you guys. If the Rag & Bones are too bougie and not in your budget, don't even sweat it. Every year, BP or Vince Camuto will put out like this dirty taupe neutral 3 to 3.5 inch heeled ankle booty. BP always tees up something that's under $80. This one I bought 2-3 years ago. And then the in-between option is gonna be from Vince Camuto. These were both from anniversary sale this year. These are the Felinas that have the cute perforation and extra exposure with no zippers on the side. And then this one is the Vince Camuto Francias. So all these guys would be pretty much that same favorite type of ankle booty because it's dressy enough with that heel height and that sleek body. If you're a person on the go, if you don't have time for all of this like crazy heel height and you need to be mobile and comfortable, without hesitation, the Franco Sarto Granite ankle booties. I got these a couple years ago at an old Nordstrom anniversary sale. They've got a beautiful rounded almond toe, so you got some nice elongation. You have a little bit of a heel height to give you some lift, but it's still low enough to walk around all day long. And then you also have like the dual zipper action like you do in the Rag & Bone, so you can get in and out, but after you seal it up, it's a nice form-fitting look, so you got a nice streamlined shoe. So those are my thoughts on the Universal Essential ankle booty. As you can see, the last thing I wanted to note is that I love this kind of like dirty taupe nude color, because if you are gonna have one ankle booty, you do want it to match a lot of things. And there's something about this that matches really well with light colors in addition to your denim blues and also your blacks. All right, so we covered ankle booties. Let's talk about the next essential shoe, which is a pair of tall boots. My number one favorite and just a style that I've fallen in love with the past few years has been the slim fitting over the knee boot. These ones that I have here were the Steve Madden Gabby over the knee boots that I got during the Nordstrom anniversary sale. This was definitely one of the most affordable ones that I've purchased. They're actually really incredibly lightweight. It's not made of anything like, you know, super hot and stifling, and it's actually thin enough to fit my chicken leg inside. Heel is thick enough to be like visible and give me a little bit of lift, but it's still flat and chunky enough to be like easy walking all day. So it's really cool because I can take these to a dressy event and wear them with like dresses, but they also look really great in jeans. So those were my most worn ones this year. But if you guys are not into anything super high fashion and tight fitting like that, my immediate alternative would be the classic riding boot. You can never go wrong with a pair of riding boots, and especially if you guys don't wear skinny jeans and wear something like a bootleg jean, you guys need a looser shaft to be able to accommodate all the extra fabric. So if you guys have a more casual classic style and you guys wear looser jeans, these are going to be a great alternative. If you guys are looking for a more rugged, amazing quality investment pair, can't go wrong with Fry. They make a badass boot, and these are more of like, you know, my Texas Western style. Or if you want some something a little bit more dressier and cutesy, I really like these Sam Edelman ones. I like them because they're more of a rounded toe. They've got a very just clean, simple look, and the suede also provides a more softer look. So just two different examples of the different riding boot routes you can go. If you guys are not needing a dressy boot, if you are in harsh climate or you're outdoorsy and you need like a good utility tall boot that will work hard for you, I am absolutely in love with the brand Sorel or Sorrel. I can't figure out how to pronounce it, I'm so sorry, but they have such a wide array of different shoes that are made for extremely cold climates that are weather resistant, water resistant, and the two favorites that I have are going to be the heavy duty Joan of Arctic. This is one of their hero shoes. Super hard rubberized shell in addition to the top of the footbed to keep your feet dry. Super thick insulation up the shaft, and then you have this cute little removable fur piece to keep your legs really warm. And then for something that's a little bit less harsh, I love the Carly tall boots. They are so military and rugged and badass looking, and these have honestly replaced my rain boots because I can wear them during the winter time, a bit area to keep my feet dry, but they're not so, you know, heavy duty like the Joan of Arctic. And the final essential shoe that everyone needs is gonna be your go-to pair of heels. You guys are already know which one this one's gonna be. My favorite all-time heeled shoe is going to be the Sam Edelman Hazel pointy-toed nude pumps. These are probably my most worn shoes on the channel, and if you are a working person or just need like one pump to last you a lifetime, this would be my go-to pair. This shoe actually comes in a lot of different colors, but I really love just the plain nude color. If you find a shoe close to your skin tone, it's just gonna give you that beautiful elongating effect, and there's just something about like the vamp and the pointy toe and the slim stiletto that just looks like Christian Louboutin, Manolo Blahnik, but for a fraction of the cost. blah, 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 blah. All right, and then alternatives, if this shoe is just a little bit too sharp and too much for you, another silhouette you can try is going to be something with a chunkier heel, so you have more stability with your walking and easier to balance. And you can also do a softer rounded toe box, so it's less harsh and pinchy on your little toesies. This particular pair I got during the Nordstrom anniversary sale, Louise Etsy, I think is the brand name, and I got this really pretty blush velvet color because it was different from my nude smooth leather, but it still has that nice neutral effect. And then this last option is if you don't have like a professional office, if you go to more dressier events or you like to party, like I did want to serve this one up. This one is a Vince Camuto heeled sandal. The single strap and thin ankle strap combo is a really popular high heel shape, and it's in that same nice smooth nude leather, so it matches with a lot of things. But if you are a party girl or you want something that's a little bit more slinky and fun, this is a really cute option. All right, guys, so that does it for my 6 essential shoes that everyone should own. You got your everyday flats, comfy pair of sneakers, summer sandal, ankle boot, tall boot, and your go-to heel. I think that if you have something in every single category, I feel like you really have all your occasions covered. I hope you appreciate my favorite picks in addition to the alternatives that I sprinkled in. I hope I covered a lot of people's needs out there. A lot of the shoes, I apologize for them being past seasons. I kind of dove through my Nordstrom archives. I have linked updated versions of everything down below in that description box. If you guys like these wardrobe basics type of talking videos, please be sure to let me know down below in the comments. I would love that. I love you guys so much. It's been forever since I've been in front of the camera talking to you guys, and it feels amazing. I miss you guys so, so much. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. Please be sure to follow me at Miss EJ Louie on all my social media if you guys want to hang out with me outside of this YouTube channel. I hope you have an amazing, blessed rest of your day. Talk to you guys real soon. Bye.